Beginning in 1947 was a state of political competition between America and the Soviet Union deemed the Cold War. This led to the urge from both countries to be the first country into outer space and eventually the moon, which in turn caused the race to space. On the 20th of July in 1969, NASA succeeded in their goal of bringing the astronauts aboard the Apollo 11 to the moon with close to flawless accuracy. And while many credit the crew of the spacecraft, or those who built the rocket ship, Margaret Hamilton is the woman who took America to the moon. Hamilton is an American computer scientist, systems engineer, and business owner, and in her early 30s she began working on the technology behind the Apollo 11. However, before her work at NASA, she worked on the SAGE project that was an extension of Project Whirlwind started by MIT to create a computer program that could predict weather systems and track their movements through simulators. The project was eventually developed for military use in anti-aircraft air defense from potential Soviet Union attacks during the Cold War. Hamilton was actually the first person to get the SAGE project to work because she was a beginner at the time, and this meant being assigned to a project that no one could ever get running before. The SAGE project was especially challenging because the person who wrote it made all of his comments in Greek and Latin. But none of this stopped Hamilton because she got the program running and all of its answers were even printed in Greek and Latin. Hamilton's success on this project is what made her a candidate for the position of lead developer for Apollo flight software at NASA. It was around this time that Hamilton also coined the phrase software engineering to gain legitimacy for her work because it was not taken seriously at the time and even considered similar to the typing and filing secretaries did. Over time, the term software engineering had gained the same respect as any other discipline that involved engineering. Hamilton was already considered unusual for being a working mother in the late 1960s, but because of using the phrase software engineering, combined with other abnormalities for the time, like bringing her four-year-old daughter to work on evenings, Hamilton was absolutely radical as a spaceship programmer. In 1965, Hamilton became director of the software engineering division of the MIT Instrumentation Laboratory that developed the programming for the NASA Apollo project. She was responsible for supervising a team of 100 engineers, mathematicians, programmers, and technical writers, the team that developed the code for the Apollo 11. Hamilton and her team were programming the spacecraft that would take America to the moon, but little did they know they were also hatching what would grow to become a $400 billion industry in America. The biggest contribution that Hamilton paid to the Apollo 11 was saving its landing on the moon. Hamilton created a feature called Asynchronous Executive, that meant the computer would recognize when it was in danger of overloading and drop low-priority tasks. Many people said that there would be no need for this feature, as the astronauts were precisely trained and never made a mistake, but Hamilton coded it in nonetheless. And it's a very good thing that she did, because when Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin were about to land on the moon, something went wrong aboard the spacecraft. Their checklist had an error in it, and it told the astronauts to activate the radar system that would be used for taking off from the moon, which was unnecessary for landing. The radar began to send the computer huge amounts of information based off of electrical noise, threatening to overload it, and had the guidance computer been overloaded, the mission would have been aborted entirely. However, the asynchronous executive feature saved the moon landing. It told the computer to ignore the information from the rendezvous radar, so the computer automatically rebooted and the spacecraft landed. Hamilton wrote on the incident, "If the computer hadn't recognized this problem and taken recovery action, I doubt the Apollo 11 would have been the successful moon landing it was." Thanks to Hamilton, the Apollo astronauts came home. Hamilton's achievements and innovations also go beyond the triumphs of playing an important role in getting humans to the moon. Hamilton, along with many other female engineers alike, challenged the male-dominated technology field of their time, allowing for women to enter these STEM fields for many years to come. Hamilton played a vital role in the moon landing, but also in the increase of female scientists. For her efforts on the Apollo 11 project, Hamilton received many striking awards. In 1986, she received the Augusta Ada Lovelace Award that is given to individuals who have excelled in outstanding scientific and technical achievements and extraordinary service to the computing community through their accomplishments. In 2003, she was given the NASA Exceptional Space Act Award for her scientific and technical contributions. This award included $37,200, the largest amount ever awarded to any individual in NASA's history. And on the 22nd of November in 2016, Hamilton was bestowed with the Presidential Medal of Freedom from Barack Obama, the highest civilian honor in the United States. Barack Obama said that Margaret Hamilton symbolizes the generation of unsung women who helped send humankind into space. Hamilton also noted in an interview that after the moon landing in the new world of computing, there were no footsteps to follow in, and no one else knew what they were doing. And yet, she and her MIT colleagues went on to write the code for the world's first portable computer in the 1970s. And although it is a smaller feat in her career, it is still extraordinary for the brand new field. And from the 1970s onward, Hamilton used her expertise to found her own software business. Because of Hamilton, the Apollo program has remained a touchstone for innovation since the 1960s. It was the triumph of a vision that helped inspire later generations of entrepreneurs and innovators to imagine the impossible and then make it a reality, just as Hamilton did. As we recall the Apollo program and the amazing victories of Armstrong and Aldrin, we should also offer praise to Margaret Hamilton, a true innovator who took humanity one giant step towards the future while also taking a crucial step for women.